What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and I got to talk about something that not enough people are talking about, and it really is going to become more and more relevant over time, redefining how artists should think about how they put their music out there, and of course, accordingly, artist managers, music marketers, and all of those other people. And it really has to do with the fans, how they look at music, how we consume music today. So what is that that I'm talking about? Moods. The actual getting rid of genres and being replaced by moods. Of course, we use genres a lot today. We still use genres, but moods are something that's becoming more and more prevalent. Even Spotify has a category that's called genres and moods. And you can even find posts online that say something like, here's 21 playlists for every single mood. There's so many of these things. Workout, happy day, rainy day, sunny day, winter time. There's so many of these types of moods, and it really does affect how people listen to music, how consumers, fans consume your music. And it's basically really something that everybody has always been doing, but because of streaming, you know, Spotify, Apple, all of those good things, more and more people are playlisting constantly. And when you create a playlist, what are you doing it for? You do it for a party, you do it for whatever the environment that you want to listen to. And this is why more than ever, it's important for you to understand who you sound like in terms of not, do you sound like an artist? Are you a carbon copy or something like that? But understanding in what environment people want to consume this type of music that you make. And you might make different types of songs for different moods, but understand maybe that's easier for you, as a matter of fact, as an artist, to say, this is a song that makes me feel like this. Where are some other songs that feel that way? It's not too much about internalizing you and comparing yourself to somebody else. It's really just about understanding what type of environment and what type of energy would somebody be in when they want to listen to this type of music. The better you can match moods, the better that you can find the right person at the right time. Because at the end of the day, that's all it is. How many times have you heard a song in one place and you didn't necessarily like it, then you heard it in another place and you loved it? Or just because you heard it at this club and so many people were loving it, it made you say, this song, like I rock with it probably a lot more than I would have liked it if I found it in the car at first. There's different songs for different places and energies. And now that you understand that, you should be able to just step back, look at a song, and figure out where people want to hear it, what's the energy. Other than that, I would love to know what you guys think as always. And if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button. If you like, you might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.